Hello, good day everyone. Welcome to Timeless TV. Please subscribe and click notification bell. Thank you. If you have subscribed before, thank you and God bless you. A player in the Italian third division Serie C has tested positive for coronavirus. He is believed to be the first case of a footballer in Europe to be infected with the coronavirus. BBC in a live update identified the player as Paul Akpan-Udo, who is an Italian-Nigerian footballer. Udo is a 22-year-old player who plays for Penense in Serie C. He was said to be diagnosed on Thursday and had been quarantined. A statement from the Tuscany region reads, two new suspected positive cases of coronavirus in Tuscany. Both are awaiting confirmation by the Higher Institute of Health. One is a 22-year-old man in the Sinai province, a Penense player, who last Saturday had symptoms in a hotel in Alessandria, where he was training with the team ahead of Sunday game at Juventus U23. He did not play the game that morning as he had a high fever. The team returned to Pancia Castiano, where he went home. Wednesday morning, he was tested in his home, and the result came back as positive in the evening. Since early this morning, he is at a hospital in Sinai. In isolation, he is in good healthy condition. Another player of the team felt the same symptoms, which the club is tracking. He put himself in voluntary quarantine before doctors decided to test him. The infected footballer is in stable condition, the report also said. It is the first case of a footballer being tested positive for the virus, and it is not known if his other teammate contracted the virus. So let's put them in prayers. This is the Italian man, the super spreader in Italy, the coronavirus patient zero. He said he contacted the coronavirus disease in Chinese Massage Center in Rome, and he continued to travel all around Italy. So now many Italians now have been infected with the virus. He's out to plead for forgiveness. And also in Nigeria, an Italian man has been diagnosed with coronavirus. He was coming from Milan, so he dropped down to Lagos. Within 2 days, he has traveled to many cities in Nigeria. So I don't know what is the opinion. And lately, he fell sick in Ogun State, where he worked. So the doctors now tested him and find out that he's coronavirus positive. So some Nigerians are very worried, and these are some of their words
and reactions.
It's not a pleasant one. If what's happening in China decides to repeat itself here, are we, as the Nigerian government, the Ministry of Health, are they all geared up? I understand that there are measures, enough measures that the government has put in place, and Ministry of Health has put in place to ensure there are checks at our entry points, the airport, and all that. But how ready are we as Nigerians for this kind of situation?
There's supposed to be a kind of a sensitization all around the places. Sensitized schools, market women, villages, everywhere. And even our airports, our borders are very, very porous in Nigeria. Our government should start taking things serious.
We had to close down for a week. That's throughout the whole of next week. We are not coming in for our usual training again because of the virus. Said the government has found a more precise measure for controlling the virus.
In Italy, everything is being secretive for now about the coronavirus news. So they are lowering the ways they are announcing the victims and the dead victims. So they don't want people to get afraid of Italy. They don't want people to stop traveling to Italy. So that is it. And China has been doing that for long. And what is happening there is that Italians has been so xenophobic to Chinese people. They are fighting Chinese people on the street, in the supermarket, everywhere. So please, I want to beg Italians, please stop this. Stop fighting Chinese people. Because what has happened has happened. No one knows it will get to this extent. Is even Italian man that took the disease now to Nigeria, to Africa, to Egypt, to Algeria, to Spain, to many countries. No one is fighting them. So stop the racism and just stand together to fight the coronavirus disease. Please, everyone should stay indoors and stop traveling. Italians should advise their citizens to stop traveling. They should advise them to stay indoors so that this disease can be contained, so that it will not get out of hand and spread to the whole world and kill everybody. So that is it. In Italian, many things are happening that they don't want to announce it anymore. So it is left for you that is there to use your brain anywhere you are to stay indoors. So this is the video about the Filipino man attack. So it's so bad, you know, as you can see. So let's stop fighting all around. Just let's stand together, pray together, and stop this deadly disease spreading all over the world. If you haven't listened to the Italian boy, this is the video. You will watch the video now and hear from him.
Buongiorno a tutti gli italiani. Questo è un video di scuse nei confronti di tutti voi. Sono stato io il primo italiano a prendere il coronavirus e a portarlo in Italia. Non sono uscito prima allo scoperto perché avevo paura. Paura del giudizio della mia famiglia. Sono io il paziente zero. Il virus l'ho preso all'interno di un centro massaggi di questi cinesi. Io purtroppo non potevo uscire fuori e costituirmi perché sennò avrei fatto una pessima figura davanti alla mia famiglia. Ma adesso la situazione è precipitata e quindi non posso più rimanere in silenzio. Ho contratto il coronavirus all'interno di un centro per massaggi di questi in cui hai l'happy ending finale. L'ho preso prima a Roma, poi i centri hanno iniziato a chiudere, quelli che frequentavo, perché le persone si ammalavano, chi ci lavorava dentro. Così mi sono spostato e ho iniziato a frequentare dei centri massaggi a Milano. Anche lì le persone all'interno del centro massaggi iniziavano a star male e a chiudere. Così mi sono spostato in Puglia e mi sono fatto i centri massaggi giù in Puglia, Lecce, Bari. Anche lì la stessa cosa. E allora mi sono spostato un po' più su e sono stato in Campania, poi in Sardegna e alla fine sono tornato qui a Roma. L'ho fatto sì, forse per egoismo, ma io in realtà non sapevo che cosa stesse succedendo. Io avevo una tosse, della febbre, ma una banale influenza, pensavo. E invece poi si è scoperto che si trattava di coronavirus. Io chiedo scusa a tutti gli italiani. Adesso però ho capito che ho sbagliato e proprio oggi mi recherò all'ospedale di mia spontanea volontà. Farò prima scorta, andrò al centro commerciale e farò provviste per la mia famiglia. Quindi mi caricherò di tutto e di più. Svuoterò più supermercati possibili. Dopodiché andrò di mia spontanea volontà in ospedale e mi costituirò. Chiedo ancora scusa a tutti gli italiani.